Hi, I'm Kayla with the Alice Ferguson Foundation, and today we're going to talk about adaptations. You are probably wondering why I'm giving you jazz fingers, and that is because my fingers are adaptations. They are a part of my body that helps me to survive in my habitat. For example, they help me open snacks. But we're not here to talk about me. We're here to talk about fish and their adaptations. Let's go take a look. All right, first up, how to read a fish. Here's the deal. Every part of a fish's body can actually tell us something about how it lives its life. So for example, the mouth. Depending on which way the mouth is facing, can tell us where it eats and even what it eats. For example, an upward facing mouth like this tells us that this fish eats food on the surface or above the surface, such as small insects or fish. In contrast, if a fish has a downward facing mouth like this one, we know that it eats food along the bottom, such as plants, crustacean, or things it finds in the mud. Next up, fish's body shape and color. If a fish is slender and aerodynamic looking, we know that it's meant for speed or maybe swimming in strong currents. If a fish is round and full-bodied, we know that it's slow moving and likely spends its time on the bottom feeding in the safe cover of vegetation. The color of a fish can tell us about the habitat that it lives in because its color is often used as camouflage to blend into its surroundings. If a fish is spotted, it probably hides or lives near rocks and gravel. If a fish has a white belly and a dark top, it's far less visible to predators swimming above or below. How? Think about it. When you look up toward the sun, what color do you see? What about when you look down into the water? What color then? Next, what does a fish's eyes look like? If a fish has big round eyes, it means it needs its eyes to find its food. If a fish has small eyes, it means it uses its other senses to find food and may live on the bottom or be nocturnal. Speaking of fish senses, did you know that fish have a sense that we don't have? It's called a lateral line. They use it to detect electrical pulses in the water. Some fish use this to detect danger or prey. All right, time to put it all together and read this fish. This fish is spotted, which makes me think that it lives near gravel. It is medium bodied. It's pretty slender, but maybe a little bit round. So it's probably a medium speed swimmer. Its mouth is faced upward, which makes me think that it eats things above it. And its belly is white and its top is dark, which makes me think that it swims in the middle of the water so that it's camouflaged against predators swimming below or above. All right, it is time to play Frankenstein and create a monster. I mean a fish. We shall call it FrankenFish. So in order to create my FrankenFish, I need this document. As you can see, each adaptation is placed into a different table. So we got body shape, we got coloration, position of mouth. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose one adaptation from each category. And then I'm going to use my artistic skills to put all those adaptations together and create my FrankenFish. All right, I've got all of my things ready to go here. I've got my fish friends for inspiration. I've got all of our fish adaptations to choose from. And then I went and grabbed a bunch of art supplies. You can grab whatever you want to create your FrankenFish, whatever art supplies you have or whatever you feel comfortable. Just let that creativity flow and create your fish. Here we go. I present to you the coral chomper fish. So as you can see, I've labeled my fish to identify which adaptations I chose. So my fish is very colorful because I imagined it living on a coral reef. and it just spends its day as a very slow swimmer with those rounded fins just drifting over the coral reef, and it uses its big mouth, downward facing mouth, to munch on coral all day long. And that is my fish. I hope that you all had a really fun time learning about fish with me today, and I can't wait to see what kind of Frankenfish you make. If you make a really fun one and you want to share it with us, you can send it to this email address. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. See you later.